All right, so in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to work project 2 in CMG. Easiest place to start for this is to use the last tutorial input, the 2D tutorial input deck, which I called test problem 2 at the time. We'll go ahead and open that in Notepad, the DAT file. And if you remember, that was a 4x3x1 two-dimensional reservoir. It had constant pressure boundary conditions along the right side of the reservoir and no flow boundary conditions on the other sides. Anyway, obviously for project 2 we have a much different grid. We have 54 grids in the x direction and 22 grids in the y direction. The delta x there is going to be 54 grids times 130.75, and that's because our overall reservoir width is 5,753 feet, and the length is 7,060.5 feet. So for delta y, then we'll have 22 times 261.5. And for dk, we have now 1188 total grids. So 1188, that's 54 times 22, and our reservoir thickness through the depth is 100 feet, right? And again, for the top of the reservoir, this is sort of an arbitrary number, but again, we need 1188. We're still using 1,000 for the top. So here we have the permeability in the I direction, and we had specified it this way previously. Now what we're going to do is we're going to open the Nicholick permeability file. So this was all the permeability data. And what we'll do is select it all and copy it. And paste that in. To the input file here. So there's all the permeability data. For permeability in the J, we're going to say equals I. And permeability K will also say equals I. For the porosity, we also want to remove, we had a constant porosity of 0.2. We're going to remove the constant, and we're going to go back and use the data from the data file again. Copy it. And paste it in. And then from this, we should be able to save this as, and I'll save it as project 2. You can go ahead and close Notepad. And we should have a project 2. Needs to have a .dat file extension, so you could have. So we'll fix that. So project2.dat, we'll take that and we'll drag that into Builder. Okay, and we have our total number of grids there. But what we want to go over here to array properties, look for null blocks. And then in the null blocks for the whole grid, we want to right-click and edit specification, and then say set blocks to null where porosity is less than or equal to 0. And if we do that and hit apply and hit OK, then now we have there the shape of our reservoir. Now, of course, these aren't, the wells are now, they were set to certain grid blocks, so they're way out of position now. We'll go ahead and move those wells. So if we go to wells and recurrent, go to well one. We also want to change the type of well. We had them set to objector mob weight before. We want to turn them into producers. Once we apply that, it's actually going to remove the constraint. And so we'll have to go in and add a new constraint definition. And the constraint definition here is that we want to operate the bottom hole pressure of 2,000 PSI. Go ahead and hit apply. And then the next thing we want to do is click on the perf tab, and we can move this well, okay? And where we're going to move it to is we want to find the grid block location. So the XY location of the first well is, the X location is 5536. So if we just take 55, let's use our calculator, we take 5536 and divide that by 130.75, then we get 42. Now, just because of the way this works out, we need to round up to get the actual grid block number that we want to put this in. So this is going to be the 43rd grid block, right, in the X direction. So 43rd grid block in the X direction. We do the same thing for the Y. The Y location is 3,500. We're going to divide that by 261.5. So that is the 13.3, so that's the 14th grid block. So we have 43, 14, 1. That's the grid block where we want to have this. We hit apply and OK. And there you see our well 1 has been relocated here. We'll do the same thing for well 2. We're going to first change the type to a producer. Add the constraint that we want to operate bottom hole pressure. Value is 2,000. Apply. We'll move that well. And I've already done the math for all the rest of them. So it's 42, 19, 1. We can actually, from this tab, go ahead and go to well 3 and also enter its correct location, which is going to be 28, 19, 1. Hit apply, okay. We do need to go and change well 3 to a producer. Add the constraint. So now we need to add two more wells. So we'll go to well, add new. The fourth well is actually going to also be a producer. Again, 2,000 PSI. We'll hit OK. We'll add a fifth well. Now this well is going to be an injector mob weight. The constraint here is going to be that we want to operate the surface water rate at 1,000 feet cubed per day. 1,000 feet cubed per day is 178.1 barrels per day. We do need to change the locations of these two new wells. So we'll go there. Click on the perforations tab, add a new location. The fourth well is going to be 19, 13, 1. And the fifth well is going to be, this is our injector, 20, 16, 1. So there are our wells. We need to actually, if we go back to reservoir array properties, look for pressure. We need to set the original reservoir pressure to 3,700 PSI. And with that, I think that's all the changes we have to make to be able to run this. So we can, I'm sorry. There's one more thing is I want to add some dates. So originally we only had 3 dates. So what I'll do here is I'll go to add a range of dates by the day, and we'll run it out to 200 days. And so we've added 197 new days there. We'll close this. And now we can go ahead and validate with IMAX, save, run normal immediately, and run. There we've ran. So if we go over here, we should see a whole seeing the results here. Oh, I just had to refresh the tab there. And the results showed up. So now we have this project2.rf. We can drag that into results 3D. We can look at a few things, like, for example, we can look at the permeability field. So there's our permeability field. We can look at the porosity field. It looks like that. Then we can go ahead and look at the pressure. So initially, our pressure is everywhere 3,700. And if we proceed through the days, you see the pressure change first around the wells, decreasing eventually over the whole reservoir, to eventually, if we look at the 200th day, then everywhere in the reservoir should be pretty close to 2,000 psi because of that's where our bottom hole pressure wells are all set at 2,000. Right? So the only place where we have this injector, we might see a little bit higher pressures because we are injecting fluid right around in this area, well 5, which is an injector. But far away from the injectors, you should see pressures that are a little bit closer to 2,000. Okay, so another thing we can look at is if we go to Project 2 and drag that into results graph, and we can create a new plot. Let's see, for any bottom hole pressure well, we would want to look at something like water rate. So we could look at water rate versus time. So there's for well 1. We could add another one, say for well 2. Another one for well 3. And we could also add for the constant rate well, we could look at the bottom hole pressure. So well bottom hole pressure, this would be for well 5. And we can plot that on a Y2 axis. So there's the well bottom hole pressure. This is the pink line over here, and you see that it decays to eventually something pretty close to 2,000. A little bit higher, but anyway. So that's roughly how you can work Project 2 in CMG and look at some of the results.